Welcome back to StrategyQuant, which you successfully installed and set up in the previous lesson. This particular lesson is focused on introduction to build for futures using one of our custom projects, NQ Breakout Futures H1 Trade Station. So please head right into the custom project tab, find the project and simply open it. Now you can notice several sequential tasks. All of them has to be finished before StrategyQuant generates the resulting strategies. And that's exactly what we are going to look at today. I will explain the individual steps in general terms and focus in detail only on the first task, which is the initial strategy build. I will show you how to set up the basic build and what options you actually have. Now, you may be wondering, what is there to explain if I can just click the start button? And how is it actually possible to differentiate my robots from others so that I can succeed in the market with them? You know, StrategyQuant is very comprehensive and I will explain to you step by step how to set up the whole process and also how to create a comprehensive functional portfolio of robots that will trade just for you. However, many of you are seeing StrategyQuant for the very first time. That's why I will explain the basic first, because we want to make sure you understand every step of the way. The goal of this course is to give you the know-how to become a fully independent and knowledgeable trader and not a manual on how to press some green button. Now let's start with the first task, build strategies. Build is, shall we say, like a hatchery of strategies. In this step, StrategyQuant, with the help of genetics and AI, builds a large number of robots based on some basic input conditions. Within this first task, the strategies are not filtered in any way, which means that there are a lot of unsuitable and consequently unusable strategies. It is the other tasks that are used to get the best possible results. Like task number two, OOS. Out of sample test, where strategies are tested on a time range that was not included in the initial build in the first task. Then, strategies that pass the out of sample go on to be tested on different markets, first on YM in task number 3 and on the ES in task number 4. Again, strategies that pass these tests continue to the next task to be tested on different time frames. Higher one, H4 in this case, and lower one, which is M30. This is because we are initially building strategies for the 1 hour time frame, but we want our strategies to at least somehow work on different time frames too. The surviving strategies are then tested on slippage. This test simulates how a strategy would perform if it were to execute a trade under degraded conditions, for example, slightly later than planned, so under somehow worse circumstances. Another test that strategies must pass is called Monte Carlo parameters change, where we, very simply put, change the original parameter values of the strategies in some way. The last test in this custom project is also Monte Carlo, but different one. It is kind of a simulation where trades with a given probability are randomly skipped. Well, and after all these tests, we only get quality strategies, which we can then start testing on a demo account with virtual money. That was a general description of how this process works. Now, let's take a look at the first task, build. As I already mentioned, this is the place, or rather part of the process, where StrategyQuant generates a large number of strategies. But in order to generate anything at all, it needs to know the basic input values or what to actually build. First and foremost, it needs to know what platform we are building for. In our case, as you know, the engine is TradeStation. Next, for what symbol? For us, it's NQ. And of course, time frame. In this case, H1. Next thing is the data range. Just for you to know, all the data is already included in StrategyQuant by default, concretely in Data Manager, so you don't need to download anything externally. And I also need to mention slippage settings, because do not forget that for futures, slippage must be set in dollars, not in pips. So you have to convert the pip size to dollars. More of the information we give to StrategyQuant is also in the trading option tab. For example, like exit on Friday. That is whether we want a strategy to trade over the weekend or not. In the building blocks tab, we can select various conditions for build. Signals, indicators, order types, exit types, and so on. Just choose. And an integral part of this is money management, meaning how big we want the positions we open to be. With all these options, we set what robot StrategyQuant should generate for us. In the next lesson, I will explain the other tasks in more detail, especially the so-called robustness test, like mentioned out of sample, other markets, the test on different timeframes or slippage. These tests help us to get the best strategies. And that's all for us today. If you don't currently have the build of this project running, please be sure to turn it on and let StrategyQuant build 1000 strategies that we are going to work with further. Take a next step to your goal of building stable and profitable portfolio. I look forward to seeing you in the next video. And don't forget to follow our channel so you don't miss the following videos.